分析。天不了。Refresh again.Are we good? Are we good? We're not. Come on. So if you take 2 seconds, sometimes you take 2 hours. Come on, Twitch.Hey, I think it's, yeah, I got a thing. Okay, that's good. Progress. All right. Hello, how are you doing? All right. Yes, I did respond to the last one, I think, in terms of animation, because if you're looking for, like, pre-made DMX animations, I probably should move this a little closer. The best places are the website I linked to you, or to the DeviantArt group actually does have some stuff. It's just...I don't think it's well organized, so... Nope, what am I doing? I think... Can I get to it from here? Yes. There's a resource folder, but then there's actually an animation resource folder in this group for all the different premades. But a lot of these are cycles. Fairly specific stuff. I think it's in this pack...Actually, it might not be. Probably should be. I know on my DA, I have under resources my DMX pack, where I have like a whole bunch of my old videos that I have all the animation for per pony. So you can take pieces from it and use it. And I have a release there that says you can use it without permission. Just you can do whatever. You can call it your own. I don't care. So it's you can...download that and just have fun and use it for anything. So there's even some poses in there too. So that's probably one of the better places to look. Yeah, it's, but do know that if you're looking for something specific, the best way to do it is make it yourself. I've gotten to the point now with the library that I have, not from like just downloads, but from making my own stuff, isis about half of everything I animate I can steal from something else I've made. I still have, there's still like lip syncing and stuff is still always going to be pretty consistent with what that shot is, and I'm going to have to add extra detail, but the general animation for stuff, I can steal a lot of it. Poses, some general turns and stuff, I have done it before, so I just grab it from other stuff I've done. No, I'm not planning on going to Galacon. I can't remember where Galacon is. was that one in Europe? The only conventions I'm planning on hitting this year are BroingCon, BabsCon, Winnie City, and Ciderfest. That's the only ones I have planned right now. Cons can get expensive, and so going to a whole bunch in a year, I can't afford that. So I try to hit up 4, and that's it. And 2 of them are fairly local. Yeah, if it's not in America, for one, I don't even have a passport, too. That's a bit of a trip to try to take. I wouldn't be able to afford doing that. I thought we could do something different. I kind of want to make a picture. So...Let's make a picture. And as normal, though, I'm going to leave it up to everybody here as to what to make the picture from. So it could be just I like we can kind of do like we did before. Where's my straw poll? Is that really still? I thought it was straw poll dot. Nope, that's not the same one. There was a better one. Or is that all that's there now? Is that all that's left for straw poll? Oh, that me. I think that's what I'm looking for. Yes, okay. I like that one more. Because that's kind of looks like a notepad. No, as of right now, it's conventions in other countries are that's a lot of money to dump into something. A lot of trips like that, you're looking at the same spending hours as much as you would for a trip within the States, like to do like for the entire year just to go to one. And so I don't know, as of right now, no plans for such. Sorry. So, as normal, we're going to split this into pony and then situation or whatever, or how we want to go from there. So, if anybody has an idea for ponies to list out, if there's certain ones that won't work for, or the models aren't that great, I'll kind of say something and we'll put it on the list. But otherwise, list off ponies. I need ponies. Pony. And if it's simple enough, we can always do something that's like a looped animation or something. But I haven't made a picture in a while, so I kind of just did a picture of mood. The Dazzlings? No, the Dazzlings are more of a EQG. And I don't like doing that stuff. Or I don't like working with those. I prefer doing the ponies. Okay. Well, we have a vote for Derpy, and it sounds like Derpy Train. I can't make Derpy a train, but do something with Derpy and a train. We'll figure that out once we figure out the actual pony, though. All right, keep coming. Actually, I don't even know how many people are here. There's like 10 people here. Come on. I need ponies. Shining armor? Okay, we'll put shining armor on there. My OC, that always ends up on there. is this Comic Sans? I don't think so. We'll probably go about 5 or so. I don't want to break up voting too much. We're doing picture. Pone for picture. Picture. Okay. If we go off in the order it came in, we have Twilight and Fluttershy. I don't know if there's fillies of the main six. I'd have to make them. That would to make all six. That would take forever. Dolphin is not pony. We won't do dolphin. like I said, I wanted to leave it at 5, so we'll leave it at that for now. If the situation calls for a second, we can do something like that. And I'm going to allow multiples because it gives more voting option. All right, so we'll do that. If I put too many options, it starts like becoming a really, really big list. Or it's a big list with few votes on each, and that is, you can't really determine what you want to do. So give me stuff. I'm not really not surprised that Derby's winning. Shiny armor. Oh, I was gonna say, if we had it where it's just dead even the whole time. It's like a middle finger. There are Philly versions? Yeah, they are. Actually with the new Philly bodies. Thing is that to me it just looks like a small version of their adult versions. And like I would think that if you're going to do a Philly that their body would have to be changed, like their hair and everything would have to be changed to match somebody that's smaller. And so to me they just look like, they don't look like Phillies, they just look like mini-me's. Shining Armor's winning. For anybody that's just joined, we'll give you the vote thing. So, voting for ponies for Pictor. Situation is not determined. We'll figure that out afterwards. So I'm thinking this. Okay, so I just want to figure out so I'm not going forever with how many people are here. So everybody go vote. I'm going to Shikwish Shining Armor. Shikwish. It's looking like it. Which is best pony? Well, you guys didn't even pick best pony. I don't see a rainbow on there. Actually, I don't think I've done anything with shining armor. Well, I've done some stuff, but not like where he's the focus. All right, I'm gonna leave that open. But as of right now, it's looking like it's gonna be shining armor. So now we need pony to do what? All right, I need situation that pony be in. Ooh, we'll see. Catching up. I'll call it in a minute here, but what pony be doing? I guess it kind of depends on the pony that's picked. Uh-oh. I'll give it 30 more seconds. So, it comes around to 45 seconds there. Cuz it's neck and neck. If it's tied at that point, I'll just flip a coin. Actually, the last time I think I did a picture of my OC one as well. It tends to win in the end. Oh wow, I have a Sacagawea. Okay, so right now we're at tie. So that's the way it's gonna be. We're gonna flip a coin. So we will do it where since Argo starts with A, I'll do A as heads. So heads, okay. Me. Wonderful. Okay. Now, Argu Pony do what? I could put them both in there. I mean, if a situation calls for it. It's really hard to pick two ponies at the beginning and then try to find a situation for it because it brings it down to just a very few possibilities. But when you have one pony and then you build a situation, you might be able to add some on top. Head on a plate. No, I don't want to go dark. Cleaning. No, we're not doing mermaid outfit.
Why not?
No. No, because I know if I put cleaning, you guys are going to vote for it. I don't want it because it's gonna no. It's like the Lustful Argonian Maid. I forgot what the name of that was from Elder Scrolls. I forgot what she was called. Racing Dash. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll see. I'll put rainbow on there, but that we can just see if later if that'll actually work. Yeah, I don't want to have it be because I don't have my OC out there much, and if suddenly when I'm using it here or more, if suddenly it's just a bait outfit everywhere, I don't want that to become what is my OC known for. I don't want to have it be that it's that is the way he's supposed to look, because that would just be weird. Um, Okay, so hiding. We'll put unknown. Helping Fluttershy with her animals. Put that on there. What's cleaning? They mean cleaning because that's the maid outfit that I had that they had my OC in because it was a joke, but I don't want that to become the norm. So, from doing a sonic rain boom, there's a particle out there for it, but that's actually pretty simple for me, and a little cliche. I'd rather do something a little different. Hiding from shining. I don't know where the reference would be for that, or if there what detail would be. Washing your maid outfit. That could kind of work, but it would be kind of just a chuckle and then thrown to the side. Argo at the studio. Okay, Argo. Okay. Alright, I'll take one more. Argo and train. Okay, I'll just put train. What that entails, I have no idea. We'll just leave it at that. Okay. So here, have the poll. Did I close the other one? I want to see if that changed at all since we started. Yeah, they're still tied anyway. Not like it matters. I called it. Because I think the last time... Oh, Argo the Mass Effect mech. No, actually, I don't think I have that mech anymore. I think it's actually gone. Oh, I haven't actually made a thing yet. Because I think it was a... remove the workshop, and I finally accidentally hit OK to remove unsubscribed, and I got rid of like 7 models. And I think that was one of them. You guys are. See, this is what I think of multiples. Is it still there? Oh, actually, I think that's a better one. Yeah, I don't think that they had the glass broke one before. Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't think they did before. That's got to be pretty new. No, that's the old one. I swear I had that, but I don't think I had the broken glass one. Come on, can't have a 3-way tie. I'm gonna be mixing a hot new mixtape with Fluttershy and animals on a train. I actually think it would be kind of cool to do like a spacesuit mech kind of thing. Mixtape with animals on the train. Is that what we're gonna do? No, I'm not going to be a train. I'll probably do something on a train. Are you rubbing a rabbit on a train while head bobbing a Fluttershy? I don't know if anybody's done anything with helping Fluttershy with their animals. I think it probably has been, but I just don't know if it's been stuff that's been out visible for people to find. No, now it's hiding's catching up. Come on. Oh yeah, I probably should be for anybody that's wanting to get here. I'll give it one more minute. Then we gotta move forward. So, doing votes for what we're making a picture of my OC doing something because that won the vote. So we need to vote for what we're doing with them. What was I gonna do? Whatever. So, okay, yeah, we'll give it 30 more seconds here. So, we're giving it until it comes back around back to here. So, come on. We need a tie. We can't do a 3-way tie, man. Need something to win here. Hiding. Heidi's winning. It's got 15 seconds. The train's caught up a little bit. Come on, you. All right, we're at the time's passed. We're at a 3-way tie. So, is anybody gonna break it? Come on. Nobody make dupe accounts. I don't even know if you can do that. I don't think I put IP locking in there. Okay, well, I haven't voted myself. So if it's going to come down to this, I'm going to pick hiding from mechs. No. And if I had to say which one would be the most fun to do here, I'm probably going to... because I've been having fun with a lot of darker scenes right now, the hiding from some pony would actually be the most fun. Because I've been playing with the Chrysalis model. It would actually be fun to play with that one again. So, if I had to pick one of these three, because you guys are indecisive, I'm going to go with that one. So, screw you guys. Since you can't make decisions, we'll go with that. I forgot the name of that map. Was it John? No. I'm trying to remember the names of the maps from Dear Esther. Because that cave map, because if I'm doing anything with Chrysalis, it's going to be the best. Actually, now that I think about it, I should go download. I should go download the one thing. Resource. Because I don't think I have the new changelings downloaded. And they look really good. Did he actually set them up to override the other ones? I mean, I'm fine with it because I don't really use them, but it's not a very good idea. Windows Explorer stopped working. Okay. Let me see if it didn't cut anything out. Doesn't look like it. That's good. Alright. So, is it Paul? They have some weird names. I already have the idea of what the picture I would make in my head is. I think I got it right. Nope, I didn't. It's the outside one. This is actually a really pretty map, though. I had an idea for a partial video on this map. Actually, I think this is even with tone map set to that. If you put the tone map down, for the darker levels that it's supposed to be, this is actually really good looking. So, actually, this might work because there is some cave bits, but I think I'm gonna have to get to the other ones. Because the thing is, when you get out of the cave, yeah, you get out of the cave right here. You get some really cool shots. Straight up SFM and every add-on. What do you mean add-on? Like workshop stuff? Because workshop doesn't work if your like account isn't connected, or I'm trying to remember some of the other reasons. But if it's installed, it should be there. So even if the votes are different now, I have to call it at some point. That's why I said I called it. So it's not this one. I can't remember which one it was. It's probably going to be, I don't think it's S there. I think that's the beginning of it. Yeah, there's, I think, 4 or 5 different maps that Esther has. And they're all pretty good, but you have to download the fixed ones that somebody did. Yep, that is Esther. Okay. Is this, because I know if you're not logged in or something, that your workshop will disconnect stuff. That's about the only way I can think of. Would that work? No, there's not really a hide location. Yeah, like I said, I can't like change it when because somebody else voted on something. That's why I said I have to call it at some point. So if something changed at this point, I'm not gonna go back for it. Trying to find a good wall just to hide behind. That could kind of, no, not really. I kind of like how it looks from this angle back here. I cannot remember. I downloaded these maps years ago. This is a fixed version, because if you actually use the Esther maps as they come in, they're really broken. So this is the fixed version that somebody went and made. Alright, let's go up here. I'm already doing something in this room, so I don't want to use that like, twice. It's a lot of painting. Let's see what at least works on this. I had problems before getting rid of some of these. Oh, that doesn't get rid of the paint. I guess that's part of it. Is it a part of the decals? Ropes, no. Beams, no. Okay. Okay, why does this map behave, but I can't get the other one to? I have another one that when I exit the shot and go back in, it keeps throwing the models back in. Is there water? Oh, there's water. Trying to find a good shot because I want it to be dark, because I'm looking for a kind of silhouette. Is that just fake? Oh, nope, there's just water at the bottom of the hole. Thought there you could fall down there or something. Okay, that'll work. What's this? Oh, that's where I came out. The water thing. This is the water pit that I don't want to use. This is a different one. I think I might go back to that first spot. Ooh! Could work. Too much water down here, so it has to be up higher. Could make this work. Try restarting it, because like sometimes if you do, if you're not logged in, you go to start, it's just, it'll say like your workshop items won't connect or something. I've had that happen before. I'm not gonna say it's gonna solve the issue, but it could definitely be a cause. What else could do it? Ensure that the workshop folder is a part of your library within your user mod folder here, and it should default to have this. There's a file called gameinfo.txt. Make sure that workshop is on this list without any slashes in front of it. Because if it's not there, that means it's actually not loading anything from the workshop. Okay, so that's me. Hello, me. We're gonna load in Chrissy. I think I was gonna have to cheat the lighting out of her. I might still have to, but okay. Just want to figure out if this position is gonna work, so I have to kind of jam myself in the ground. So if I were to put myself like down here, works good. Yes, I know sometimes that crap like that happens. So I probably can't have a high aperture for this. Higher than that, though. Usually I keep the ideas down to whatever the situation is. So the next thing I do, I'll just be running another vote for. Only thing I don't think will work with this is that I kind of wanted to have other changelings around too. And so I kind of wanted a more of an open space. And I don't know if that's going to work for that. But if that's the case, I don't know what would work here. Really, this room works for a lot of stuff, but I've already got something going with that room, so I don't want to use it twice. To the top here. This is way too lit, though. You know what? I can put a rock here and get it to work. But I'd have to have it like it should be so far away. I just don't think it would work for that either. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with what I have. I know, I kind of thought about that when I said it. So we'll keep it here and see what happens. I think I still have her teeth set to glow. Yeah, they are. Okay. Yeah, it's blurred anyway. Probably would actually make her mane glow a little bit too, because I don't want her eyes actually showing. But there's this cool little thing you can do, and I just have to remember how to do it, because I forget every time. Yes, it is. Okay, cool. So you can redirect a, or every model has it set. Like, if you're moving within a map, you'll hit a point where you'll notice that the light will drastically change when you move it from one area to another. That's because, like, a point on that model that is designated as that point's, or that model's light point is entering that area. You can redirect that. That's what this Illume Position DAG is. And so, by copying the one from this other model and pasting it as a reference on the other model, it becomes the same value of whatever this model is that I'm moving. So I can move it wherever I want. So I can move it to somewhere that, like here, that's lighter, and she will take in the map lighting of that higher lit area. Or, and this is what I actually want it to be, is I find an area like this that is pure black. And now she is ignoring all map lighting, but only map lighting. So if I spawn a light, I can still light her, button, I'm no longer having to deal with what the map is giving me. This works pretty good, or works really well in dark maps if you can throw it and find a, like a perfectly black area that has no light. With lit maps, it's a little bit harder because you have to find an area of the map that is still lit correctly for... You don't want to make it pure black in the middle of a lit area because lighting it to fit is going to be almost impossible. But the nice thing about being able to do this is that you can pick a specific spot, like right by that model, lock its lighting to that, so if it crosses into a section that's going to have the light blink into another brightness, kind of like when I moved this, how it does this, so suddenly bam, you can put it somewhere that it won't do that then. The model is going to be locked to whatever it was. So the way I did that again was I went into the model viewer or the element viewer with that model, and it has the Illume Precision DAG. I just copied that, the whole thing, and you only can paste from one type of to another. So this is the EME DAG, so it's copied from that. Then I went to the Chrysalis model, found its one, and I deleted the one that was there, so it was completely wiped. And then I just went on top and said paste special reference. That's all it was. So, and now I can have a much easier time in lighting this. So I'm going to say this is bag volumetrics. I'm going to grab. And that was I learned that, I think, through Max of 2SD or whatever. He had a video on it a long time ago. But now it allows me to better lighter. I heard you guys talking about it. Argo speakers. I'm also a cornstarch. I guess. Here, you can get it at Target. Argo cornstarch. It's good stuff. I think. On this, no. I'm working on something else that might. I have a different idea, and I just don't know if that area is going to work for it. Because like I have, I'm having to highly restrict her locations. to make it work. I need to really see if I can find something that's a bit more open. Like here, if you can see the ground a bit more, it might work, but it just seems to like fade into a nothingness blur. Well, actually, where's Chris? I'm gonna see if... Now, no matter where I move her now, she should still ignore all the lighting. Get in the hole. I'm curious if I put her at the very bottom in the water if she has a reflection. Because a lot of this water does. If that's the case... then actually this could have some neat implications. Is you can't have her I wonder if I was gonna try something quick. Still see the stubs. I want to make it look like I could, like she's standing in the water by cutting off her feet. But no, it's too drastic. Because the water looks great, but it looks great from high angles. As soon as you start getting down into like a lower angle, it starts destroying it because you can see straight through the water. And I don't really have a way to modify those values. Yeah, so you can still see your hooves just perfectly fine through there. So yeah, that doesn't really work either. So I'll scrap that. Back with you. So the bottom of this. Oh, that is where I am. Because the darkest lit areas are small tunnels. Oh, I forgot about this room. You know what? Actually, there was a different room very much like this that was darker. Yeah, here we go. This could work. Just gotta find a hiding spot. Right here. I wish it was more visible of the hill, though. I think it's gonna be the best spot. Good night. Thanks for the well wishes. You too. swear I downloaded the pod for, what do they call that? The Chrysalis pods. That is a change dish. Oh, there it's changeling cocoon. I think I found it. Only thing is, it's so transparent. I don't know if that's because of how the lighting's hitting it. I never understood why it was so transparent. I know it's probably supposed to have a pony in there or something, but just doesn't look right from there, so I might just leave those out. For some reason, I couldn't think of how to spell cocoon, but coo. Okay, for how? Lighting-wise, that should be fine, but I'm probably going to do the same thing with mine. Or my model, so I'm going to take the light here. I'm gonna grab this thing's illumination position, and I'm just gonna paste it to mine. There, now I'm back. And that's because this now I match perfectly with this, so if I light the surface, I'm lighting myself evenly. Chris C would probably, I was going to put it right here. No, I'm disconnected. Might actually increase your size a bit. Make sure that she's visible from wherever, and I want to keep her mainly at a profile. As it is though, this would require that her body be up a lot higher and angled down. These back legs aren't going to work very well for anything. Their bones are so close to each other. I'll make this one the forward one. Sometimes there's no way I'm going to be able to bend that leg the way I want it to without... Oh. I'll be able to if I lock this one. No, not really. Still going to be busted. But that's the nice thing about Photoshop. You can kind of just fix that crap. You can't go and tell me the prank before you do it. Now I know it's coming. So it doesn't work. And actually, I used to not really be a fan of changelings, but I really like working in darker maps and stuff, not because emo or any of that stuff, but because I feel that you can usually get some of the best emotion and most of anything out of a character by using a dark shot. So Crystals and Nightmare Moon are perfect for that. So, I'm broken. Somebody fix me. Or I will fix me. There. I'm fixed. scaling models, getting the legs to behave properly. That's not her leg. Let me make sure that right now she's actually being pushed off properly. So I need to make sure she's actually leaning on this leg. Much. So you make sure that one eye is visible and not the others. play with the other. One here. Yeah, I probably should just have it still hang down right in front of her eye. I think it's gonna look the best. That could work. The eyes I'm hoping to not make visible. So. If you're getting black, purple and black textures, so when you load stuff, it just means that the map itself is located, but the textures are usually in the wrong location. So it's just making sure that whatever is in the materials folder, whatever you downloaded, is put to the correct directories. If it's the Dear Esther ones, that's just because if you take it from the game itself, it's not going to work. There's fixed ones out there you can download for free. Have you ever thought of making a story for a C, if so, with Flat Beat? No, I've never thought of making a story, and nor have I ever cared to. The C is just supposed to be a representation for me to the community, but in no way is do I use it for really anything else. There's no expected story, no idea to come from it, nothing. It's just me. created a Discord just for you guys. I don't really pay attention to those chats. I'm on like 5 Discords and I don't pay attention to it. Hell, there's the there's the whole Steam group on here, and there's a chat for anybody that's in there that can go into the chats and you can talk just the same on there at any point at any time. So to me, I don't see the point of a Discord really, other than potentially having the ability to actually talk with people, but trust me, I don't, it's not something I ever really do. Focal distance further up point. But yeah, I have Discord, but I got it mainly because there was just certain groups that went to it, and it got to a point where the majority had went to it, so I eventually did. But there's still, I still keep Skype, and I use still Skype for most things, just because that is the main source for individuals that I care about to talk with. Normally, if I'm not streaming, I'm just kind of gaming or something. I'm not really an exciting person. Still trying to keep her face mostly darkened. But I still have to portray the lighting correctly. Because to me, if somebody doesn't have eyes, they are usually portrayed more of being like a creature or something, but the eyes are what make them are sympathetic. It's hard to say, I guess, but... So I'm actually gonna close your eyes here. And then I could hide them myself. I think I'm gonna have to go with her eyes shown. But if I do, I can't have it. If I can have her kind of crossing her face here. She needs that over her eyes to make her who she is. But getting it positioned right, am I gonna have to turn her head a different position? Forward, it's just I just don't think it'd look as good. Her head looks way better from the other way. And I normally don't talk on the chat thing, but really. I leave comments all the time. I do know that there's a lot of people here that want to talk, and it's not that I don't socialize, actually. That's kind of jumping to a pretty negative conclusion with that. I have a lot of friends that I do deal with, or I go and hang out with on the weekends. I have a lot of people that I know locally here, and if I were to actually answer every person that wanted to talk, I would never leave the house. And so, no, I'm not gonna I don't like to open myself up for having a lot of stuff like that, because otherwise I start getting crap loads of private messages. I mean, there's a reason that on Steam I have 187 pending friend invites, because if I were to accept all of them, I would max my friends list, I would have to then start kicking people from it, and I would be getting private messages from a lot of people just saying, hey, that's a lot of people to go through, and I can't do that. So I restrict it to the people that I know, and those are the people that I usually interact with the most. I mean, that's the whole reason that I originally made the streams, was for the purpose of giving a place for that I could interact with people on a larger scale, without making certain people feel like they're being ignored. So, there was some meticulous thought though into that. Don't like how the map is lit down there. Ooh, actually, even that alone. Oh, those things are cool lighting, but I wonder if I could do something with it instead, like this. It would just take forever to fill it. Yeah, I think I'll just keep it how it is. So you get to know that, that's how it looks. If that's not a way of balancing out, that's your opinion. I'm going to deal with things the way that I'm going to deal with them. So if that's not, if you have a problem with that, that's your problem. Yep, actually she looks a lot better like that. Okay, I'm gonna do that. Just trying to keep her dark and evil looking, but I kind of like her being well lit. My OC is right there. I'm trying to figure out some of the lighting here to see if her positioning works where it is. And I think it will. I try to think of the things that will be the biggest hindrance, and I try to do those first. Because for me, positioning myself over there, that actually is going to be pretty easy. I'm more worried about, in the lit areas, making them look like they belong within that area, because you have this huge detailed area and then these cartoony ponies that are in there. So you have to make sure that they balance correctly. And that's what I'm trying to see if I can make work. Because, like, if I just take this light. High radius would probably come in handy here. Do like that. Over the hill. The shadow's on. Nope. Now it is. The radius should cause it to fade a little bit behind me. Actually, I might need to do it like this. I'm gonna probably do two lights with this. So I'm gonna do the cutoff right about here. Put a little further up. Like this. Like that, there. And I'm gonna drop the aperture a bit to make it a little more clear. Going good. How are you doing? Hello.
I have defeated the game.
Okay, now you gotta go play it again.
No, I know. Beat it for a first time. Let's put that way.
Don't picture. And I'm kind of. Things.
What up, peoples? What the hell are you doing with your OC?
Well, they said you looked dead, so I made him alive.
In a rock?
No, he should fade into oblivion. Bye, goodbye, cruel world.
Okay. Seriously, why is he in a, rock?
No, he's fine. He's all fixed.
Where's the maid outfit?
He's stuck.
Where's the maid outfit?
He's drowning, help him!
Seriously, where's the maid outfit?
We're not doing the maid outfit.
Ooh, Crystal has it in there too. Hello. What up? I just beat Final Fantasy 15. Well, I beat the story part.
Yeah, you have done almost everything else, so I'm pretty sure you're good.
I still have to beat the Adamantoys.
I'm good luck with that.
Well, I'm level 75 now.
Yeah, but still. It took me an hour and a half, so...
I thought it took you two.
It was probably somewhere in between. It took a long time.
Yeah, I don't plan on beating him tonight, that's for sure.
I didn't face him until well after I beat the game.
Yeah. But you were only, like, 40 or something when you finished 50. The game. 50?
No, it was 50 when I fought him.
Oh. I went to Altissa when I was like 70, and then I beat the game when I was 75. Tells you just how much experience you get at the end. So are you looking at the ever so elusive chrysalis?
No, they did voting for pictures, and a couple of tied, so we went with hiding. Well, they voted it for the stuff, so.
Okay, you guys are interesting, too. Okay. Your OC is cute, though. He's adorbs. I'm gonna go and see what else has changed.
a little too low. Good, go make something. I have this problem of I can never, or it takes me a while to build up in or the motivation to do anything. So anytime I have the inkling to work on something, I try to drop whatever I'm doing and just do it, because otherwise I'm never, by the time I'm gonna get around to feeling like doing something again, I'm just gonna be like, nope, too far past. Hide it underneath the thing like that. Did that work? I don't know if it actually looks that good though. I made this mistake of what I called them bloopers, and I go in. I've also had the live stream bloopers, and now I sometimes don't know which is which. At least you said first, so I'm assuming that you mean the group that I put out just a little bit ago. Then yes, that was our pretty funny. I don't know, the first group I probably, I don't know if I want to say I put more time into them or not. I'm not sure. I think I put more into the second, but it was just over so much time that I'm not, I don't know. But those are fun to make, because they're, I don't have to put much effort into them, because the, a lot of the videos are already basically done. I'm just taking video that I've already done it basically and editing it, and it makes it way easier to do anything. So because half the work's done, I don't have to scene build anything. I don't have to most of the animation's already done. So yeah, I really like doing the bloopers for the purpose of it's a lazy way to finish something. Think about it. I still have coffee over there I should grab. Oh, you know what? The big wings sticking out? Probably a giveaway. And to make this easier, I recommend if you know the shot you're doing is going to be all closed or all open, just hide them. Then you don't have to worry about them at all. Things you can get away with, nobody notices. Shrink size of wing, nobody will see it. See, I really wish that I could get the shoulder up further, like up here, but I feel like if I do it, it's just gonna look weird. Actually, no, not really. I think with the lighting comes in there, it might. City Skylines. The nice thing is if you're going to make City Skylines, nighttime is the easiest time to do that. I'll eat it in a second. I just want to go grab my rest of my coffee before it gets too late, otherwise I'm just going to be out forever. So I'll be back in a second. Bye. Skylines, it's what I'd recommend doing. I haven't actually seen the full video yet, so I'll show you an example of one I did do, in terms of how I lit it. And it depends, is it going to be a lot of close buildings in Skyline, or is it going to be only distance? Because a lot of times with the Skyline, you're going to have like varying levels with it. And I have two examples. I'm going to pull up the other one because this might work actually better. Because, like, if there's this skyline, next one, there. Picture of it. An example is going to be the best way to do it. Yeah, I thought he kind of meant the game, too, at first, but I was like, no, yeah, coffee is good. Did I get any new games? I've been actually playing Mass Effect 3 a lot, and I kind of want to get Horizon, but Mass Effect Andromeda is coming out in like a week and a half, so since she just was playing Final Fantasy, I was like, I'm just going to wait. So when Final Fantasy Andromeda comes out, I'll be like gaming like crap for a bit. Probably not even looking at this for the picture then. Because, like, if you're looking for a city skyline, the main things are a modern-day city is going to have light pollution, meaning that you're going to have a darker upper sky and a brighter horizon, even in the middle of the night, because you're going to have that glow from the city. That also means that the buildings themselves should have light coming from the bottom and getting darker as they go higher. Alright, so let's see what example you've given. If you're going to do an angle like that, good luck. Because you're going to be looking down at the city. That is a huge number of buildings to build. If you're trying to make that actually look good, it's not going to happen. The best bet you're going to have is doing it at a lower angle so that you can hide further distance with more buildings. That's what, like, what I kind of meant with this. That's why I went to that angle. Because I just had to put a couple different buildings at various distances and it gave the portrayal of a much bigger city. So, I know in here, in the picture you gave, you can see here, you can see that it's lighter at the horizon, and when you're doing animation or cartoonish work or anything that's surreal, where you're going to be potentially having that border of entering into the Uncanny Valley, you want to kind of take things to an extreme. So if it's supposed to be brighter at the horizon, you probably want to make it much brighter at the horizon. If you're going to have certain motions, you want to make them drastic. So that's why, like here, I need to make sure it was higher contrast, because when you're doing something cartoonish, everything has a higher contrast. So I have a much brighter horizon. The buildings have much more light on there, probably more than I need, but I'd rather overdo it. So that's kind of what the case is with that. So for this kind of horizon, I mean, this was like an industrial, so I had just the colors I was going for. But then, I also did the lighting for that bunny video. This one. And trying to get to the. On HD. Oh, it's raining. That's probably why. Oh, it's only at 720. Ooh. I thought there was a couple of good horizon shots. But like here, you can see I made the buildings light up from underneath. I think here for the distance, it's raining. So raining makes it so you can hide even more. So I think there's even some building stuff that was hidden there. Yeah, I thought I had better shots of it. I thought there were some wider shots in there, but I have to go through it a lot. So, but that's raining, so I guess maybe a bad example. So, the little lights in the city streets are going to be your hardest part. The easiest way to achieve it with the least lights possible is probably using a light that has a gobo on it to have small little dots. And just shine it at the buildings, because if you're going to have depth of field on, those are all going to blend into nothing anyway. So whether or not it's shining on a surface or it's shining in the whatever, it's not going to make a difference. So if you took a larger ones and just spread it over a larger area, and then you took other ones with the dots and just use the Uber lights to do it in one little cone shape, you might be able to shine that down a bit. I'm not sure. It's something that I'd have to play around with to make work. But if you're trying to look for having models and the detail of everything else in the background, that is a lot of models to throw down. And you're looking at situations like, like this, where I had a crap load of models that this scene runs like crap, and that's still not even as many as you would need. Just to portray that. But there's a lot of little low-quality models you can get that are in large sets, like three or four in a row, just really low-poly. You could just throw a bunch of those everywhere and just copy and paste. So that's about the best I can say if you're doing a shot like that, because that is not an easy shot to do. Angles where you're looking down like this, and the horizon is still visible, are immensely difficult to see and build for. I tend to try to go straight on or looking up a little bit, or it's down enough where the horizon is not visible. If the horizon is visible, I try to at least use it in such an area that I don't have to worry about the scene build, because if you want to make it look really good, you have to build so far into the distance that it's just not worth it. One of my favorite things in SFM is when you see, when you have a problem and you don't, it's like, the engine can't do this. Okay, so how am I going to make it work? It's not, I don't like saying it can't do it. It's more of, what do I have to do to get around those limitations? And I think that you should do that with not just SFM, but really anything. If something is in your way, okay, wonderful. Just, try to find a way to make it work. So, yeah, it's troubleshooting stuff is like my favorite thing to do. Oh, the eyes got moved. Now that light is probably too bright. We're gonna dumb that down to about there. So now it's balanced with everything else. I'm going to grab a new light. I'm gonna have it be an eye light. So Uber on, shadows off, cut on max, cut off min. Now I have an eye light. The only light eyes. She might find me, but I have become one with the infinite. I need to make sure that I need to completely light the whole pupil. So I'm going to go around here. Okay, and I need to make sure that I'm colored the same as everything else. So I'm going to grab these. Actually, that's for the volumetric light. I probably should grab her light. Yeah, that's the better one. Thank you. good if I'm downloading so many animation minor can't handle it. Yeah, that's fine. The more resources you have, the better. I mean, that's I've been having some troubles with SFM that I think would be solved if I reinstalled it, but I'm afraid to because I spent so much time like tweaking things that I feel like if I reinstall it, even if I back up my entire user mod, something's going to get messed up, and that scares me. And so I've always said I will reinstall it once I'm done with all my current projects, which will never happen. So I'm kind of stuck in a pickle. But yeah, the more resources you have, the better. To a degree, SFM has a library limit, which means that it cannot hold... every time it loads a model or a sound or a texture to use in SFM, it puts it into a library. And if the library gets too many objects in it, it actually will crash the software. So I've actually gotten to the point where I added too many models that by loading up the models alone, I could crash my software. I had to disable viewing some. It's also the reason that like right now, if I go to add a model, it says I have 39,543. So it's in the library, has everything loaded in. Because I did load model, I cannot go to do a gobo light or to load up a sound. Because if I do, it'll start in the background indexing everything. And in trying to index them, it will hit that limit on either of them and crash it. And I can guarantee you, for instance, I go here, so I'm going to save because I know it's going to crash. I'm just going to go to add clip to track. And you can see it's building up the library. And it'll... let's wait for it to hit its max. There we go. Out of key value space. Crash. Because I have too much crap. And... it's useful crap, but it means that if I'm going to do sound work, I have to start up SFM, do all my sound stuff. If I start doing any modeling stuff, I have to save it, quit, and load back in. It's really annoying. But it's the only way to ensure that I can have as much available to me as possible. Because otherwise, if I try to make it so I can use all at once, but I'm not using all at once, I mean, I'm not using this... sound editor at the same time as models or the same time as gobo textures, so why should I care that it does that? Really, I don't. It has some annoyances, but as long as I'm prepared for it, I can save for it. So you can download a lot of resources, but don't download useless stuff. You download the stuff that looks useful. Or break it into pieces, because when you go to in SFM, well, this is what it goes. If you go and create a game for it, you'll probably end up working out better than putting everything in user mod. So if you have a large number of models you're going to add to the program, you don't have to put it in user mod. User mod is just a directory to put it in. I have a test one here that I was working on testing some certain things. And so what you can do is... when you go to download any model, so like if I were to go to downloads here, this is the overhaul changeling. If I were to take just these two folders, the materials and models, I could just create a new folder here, like for test. I could just go like this, merge folders. I now have changelings, they're just in a different directory. And the reason you can do that is if you go under your user mod and you go under your game info.txt, this is where you can add the different directories. So here, I have test available, and actually I probably don't even need to. So what that is saying is when the software loads, it starts, I believe, at the top and starts loading down. And I believe everyone after the top ones will overwrite anything from the one below it. I can't remember what version it was. It's a priority list. And if you create another directory for stuff that you are only going to use for very certain situations, you can put it in a directory or its own game. And when you're using it, keep it on. But when you don't need it, just put a comment in front of it and you blocked it out, now it's no longer going to be indexed at all when you go to load the software. That's the only reason I've been able to use the software now, because I went and disabled a couple of these games that I have models for. So if I turn those on, just loading up the models alone will crash the software. So it really comes in handy being able to do that. The only problem is, it used to be that when SFM would update, which it hasn't for like 2 years now, they would automatically overwrite your game info file, so you'd lose all that. So usually, anytime I do any edits to this, I would go and save a copy somewhere. I used to have, because they haven't updated for a while, I haven't cared as much, but I used to have a copy of the, that doesn't matter. I don't think I have any more. Yeah, I used to have a copy on my desktop of gameinfo.txt, just because that was my backup. I just don't have the desktop. But yeah, having a lot of models comes in handy, but it's like, it does have its downfalls for that reason. Or if they're not named correctly, that can also do it. There's some models you get that are just horribly named that you're like, what the hell is this even supposed to be? And when you pull up the name, it just says like Goofy, but it's a car or something. And so if you download models that have horrible, horrible naming conventions, it's better just to not even have the model at all, because you're never going to find it. I'm in the habit of hitting F2 to rename things, and I keep doing it on here, and it doesn't work. Let's go with small, doesn't matter. Well, it's actually one of the reasons that if you look at my DMXs when it comes to naming conventions, how I did the videos was, because I made it a public thing, I put my name, underscore, the video it came from, underscore, the model it came from, underscore, if there's something special about that one's model's position, which normally doesn't matter, and then underscore V1, so that I had the ability in the future to potentially, if I needed to fix something, change it, because I don't want to change a file that somebody was using and then change the way it was being used. So I did it for all the videos. So under here you have Argo, Apple Dash, Applejack V1. Excuses, Fluttershy, Pinky, Rainbow Dash, because it's just a way, it's looking at the bigger thing, the person, the video, the pony, and that's what I did there. But then like when I came down to, when I was originally doing it, though, after a while I started just doing the pony first, because that's why I searched for specific stuff. When I did wings, I don't want to say closing wings, because if I have closing and opening wings, now they're going to be organized C and O in whole different areas. So I wanted to do the central wings and then open and close. Or like here, I have wings, the bigger one, then flap, that's what they're doing, and then the speed is a smaller subsection of the flap, so that's why I do it smaller, so I keep it in groups. So I mean, I had my own kind of naming convention. Running, sprint, because there's different types of running. Sprint was just my way of doing it. Dust was because that was the model that was made for. So, I mean, you want to at least put keywords in there that people are going to search for. If the people are going to be looking for you run within their stuff, they're going to look for run, running, sprint, gallop. Those are the words you want to use. So, you don't need to put the word pony in there, I feel, because it's, you know... And it doesn't mean that people are wrong in doing this stuff. It's just that you have to make it easy for people. The DMX files you're downloading, you don't have to really put them anywhere specific because it goes to load it for you. I created a folder in my user mod called DMX. That's just where I put them. You can just make a folder for them anywhere. You can put it on your desktop. You can put it in your user mod. You can put it anywhere. Using a other monitor for a secondary the other day, so it defaults over there. Okay, no, it's already got shadows off. Come on. There we go. Can I not hit the ground but still hit me? Let's say no. So I want something to just define me a little bit on some of these extra edges. I think that should do it. No, the DMX files are not included in that library search. The libraries are if you're trying to make are for like textures, sound files, and models. DMXs are loaded separately because you actually have to go to the model and say import. Actually, he's locked. Import animation, and then you choose the file. So it's doing all of its library stuff through the file, so it doesn't have to build up in there. So you're fine. I don't know if I'm gonna finish this tonight. If that's the case, I can finish it Friday. Because right now I have Chrysalis in there, but I actually want to have a bunch of changelings in there too. The one thing that's bugging me right now with this is the arm's on the ground, but the ground's really lit, but not him. Oh, I know how to fix this. Actually, I don't think that actually fixed it. I thought it might have. The minimum I increased, and it pushed off how the lighting was done. Because some of the shadows don't work unless you. Probably just not working because I'm close. So is that light? What I'm kind of curious about is right here. A shadow there? Because it doesn't make much sense if he's not lit there, but the rock is. That's my concern with that. And really, I could probably just take this light, copy it. That. Of better. But yeah, in terms of what you said before, yeah, I always have you guys figure out the title for the, those that don't know. So if you got to think of ones you can come up with, that's perfect. Fine. I don't pick my own with these things. That, and then I'm going to take this little light that I was using, because technically it should be lit the same as the rock. There should be a light, you could almost say, coming up over the side to light up the face a bit more, kind of like that. That will work, but I'm going to take this main rock light, paste it, cut off much farther, and then make it much dimmer. Just so I can see a little bit of detail back here, but not much. This is gonna work, but we're gonna try it. So this is gonna be rock. Actually spreads my way of doing it. This is gonna be main, this is gonna be face. Argo face. Oh, it caps, I guess. Face. And one more. I'm gonna use a face light for this. See if this works. Because I want to make sure that I'm not like hiding in the dark kind of a thing. Say I'm hiding in the dark, but I want to like actually ensure that I have some details. I'm not gonna remember any of the ones you're gonna say, so Gotta come up with them, that's fine, but I'm probably not gonna be able to take them right now. Okay, that can work. I just have to bring this up more towards the front of the body so that it's less focused on the face. Gonna take Crystal's top light here. Shadows on, no. Volumetrics on, no. I'm gonna make this nice and wide. We're going to turn off Uber. I'm gonna turn on shadows. I don't really want this lighting anything, so I'm gonna drop that really low. Pump this up. Just a little bit of change though. Oh, change, actually, I thought I had no E. Apparently I was wrong. So this is the new change thing, I think. Yeah, looks like it. Oh, change thing. Here. Yeah, that'll work. Now these guys I'm gonna probably keep pretty dark. And I want to make him look creepy. So I'm going to have this guy, like, crawling up this thing. So I need your chest one. This thing. Too big for what he's doing. Gotta be some flexes I'm missing on this. Yes, there is. Okay. I have to add those. It's tong. Oh, it's tong. Okay. Apparently it is now tong. I wish I had the plexes the other ponies have. About like ensuring that everything works with them. Because it's just going to be seen from an angle anyway. Do they have angry? Probably. Yes. They just look happy when I do that. Another stretch. I was gonna say they gotta have stretch on there. Normally I put eyelight at the beginning because I want to make sure that I keep them distinctive by changeling. There's a pupil in there. Straight over and said, are you gonna make guys go? Yes, obviously. Kind of like this. The only thing I don't like though is that there's like fake pupils. And in terms of organizing, if those haven't seen what that is, I think I still have the thing open. Yes, I do. There is a please just be auto-saving. You're gonna crash that fast. Apparently, yes. Yeah, the pupil looks weird in the changeling. I need a... I can get rid of it, though. That's not difficult. Come on, SFM. I don't think you're telling me you're thinking, but then you, 10 minutes later, are still thinking. No, the, organizing script here is located in your user mod CFG. It's the SFM default animation group. I can't remember if I saved this just before or not. Otherwise, I might not have the highlights. Aha! Actually, it's exactly where it was. And I have a heavily modified one, but if you ever have models that don't have the flexes in an organization of any way, so in here it's unknown, you can add them. I've been adding this over time. You can just see how big this is. I keep meaning to make this public, and then I never do. Mainly because I don't want to step on Zappy's toes, who originally started this. But like, for instance, I need wide R, which is the wide right eye. So the facial features are up at the top. I organized this a bit differently, too. I went through and moved things around a lot from what Zappy had. So this is upper face. Yep, upper face. So I'm going to find what was similar to... These are just different spellings. So wide R, so right here. That's what these ones are. So I want to keep them in about the same spot. So I'm just going to take... this is R wide is Ember. So I'm just going to go grab this. I'm going to say wide R. Changeling. Apparently it's the V. I don't think it... E looks weird. And then for this... L. I just keep after it's what it is, so I know why it's there. And then, like, lid rays. Okay, so this is lid rays. I'm gonna find one that looks similar to... Doesn't look like there is one. The razor. So I'm just gonna put it under razor. So let's do... lid rays. We've been doing left first then right. Left then right, so left. Paste. And then right. And then we will do lower, which would be after. Lower. See, this is even broken out differently than the other one was. I'll just do it afterwards, because whatever. These are going to be in sets anyway. Oops. Notepad++ has a feature for the Control D duplicates, so I've been, that's what I'm doing here. So if I want to, if I hit Control D, it'll just double click, create the same line. So if I create those two and I save it, if I go to the changeling now and I right-click, go to utilities and rebuild control groups, those ones will disappear because they are now up here in these groups. So I have a lot of models that I've downloaded, and that's one of the reasons that I filled up my libraries, because I downloaded a crap load of models and added them all to my libraries, so, or the script, so that I can load up lots of different models, and it comes in so infrequently to have new named flexes that that's why I like, sometimes I'm like, why doesn't this model have these flexes? It does, just the name's weird. So adding these is really, really easy, and the only difficult part is if you add something to here and an update comes across later that for some other script you downloaded, that it could potentially overwrite this file and all the stuff that you did with it. So I always make sure that anything I'm downloading doesn't have any modifications to the CFG file, so that I don't have to worry about it, because I'm paranoid about that stuff. I should probably do R there and L here. So I think we added another one. Go bam. Bam. Build. Gone. those other ones right now, though. But I do need to add more lights to have him pull out here. So this is going to be Changeling, Rim 1. And then I need to have his other light. I don't have my... The reason for this is because there is a bright light behind him. So he should actually have some light coming around his face, even if it's just by a little bit. And then it really helps pull him out of the background here. And actually, I forgot what this light actually is called. I just call it highlight because it highlights the edge. And even then, I should actually pick this light. I should probably pull it around here. Put on some radius, drop the intensity. Oh, too much radius. I actually like the way direction he's looking. I think I might actually have him pull. Actually, I think the main thing bothering me with him is that there's that pull behind his head. Right here. Yeah, there, it pulls him out a little better. I just was worried that it wasn't going to pull him out enough. Okay. Just this front leg's done. I need to get this back leg figured out then. Because right now he just looks weird. An idea, go along with it. I desert test the grassland maps, like one of my favorite maps to use. I tend to always go back to like some like either this map or I'm trying to think of actually I should probably be careful with how these lights are doing. I don't want to hit these so much. The void map is one of my favorites. I think it's me just taking that light. Yeah, it's the main one here. Don't think it's gonna work this way though. That's gotta be the changeling's rim. Oh, so it's this one. I think I need to get rid of her teeth. It looks weird from a distance. Well, actually, I need to fix her eyes. She has like giant fucking eyes right now. I'm gonna say it's an evil cave. I think for Chrysalis, I need to have her ambient light drop a little. And her room light increase. Other room. under light decreased a little bit. See if I can bend them into more higher visibility. Actually, you know what? Fuck it. I'm just trying to lay at them. From this side. I do have to light from this side. Would scalable eye textures be useful? Yes. Kind of. If it had its own slider, yes. But a lot of the times that's modifying. You can do it through using... the iRefract models allow scalable pupils if done right. I never played around with it enough to figure out how to get it to be done right, but I did figure out how to do it. But, like... A lot of what that does is it completely changes the entire size of the pupil, like the entire eye. The most useful part would be able to change just the black portion in the middle. Well, actually both if you could, the actual full thing and the pupil. But there is, with how the models are right now, because the art of the fake white lighting they do over there, over it, if you try to do that, it's gonna break it. Or like on her, it wouldn't need to be larger and smaller. It would have to actually shrink between like width, and that's stuff that's really difficult to do. At least be to make it done right. So, I mean, if anybody could make it work, that'd be awesome. But I mean, it's not something I'm gonna go and try to expect from anybody anyway. Her wing looks actually pretty good until it all fades together. I might just leave it how it is, though. Need to clear that up a little bit. Oh, the magic power one is what I made my I think Remembrance or Destiny, one of those two. Oh, that was way bigger than I expected it to be. Okay, let's shrink that down a little bit. Is way too big. 0.525. These have the Z off, don't they? Yes, they do. Okay. Well, we'll fix that. Hopefully without having to load up textures. Oops, that didn't accept. Just click elsewhere. Okay, got that fixed. It okay. No Z means that it ignores. It ignores if there's things around. It ignores surfaces, so that you can just see it through everything. I forgot why this one had that on. Yeah, I'm still working on that. I kind of wanted to get these out of the way. So let's do 2D5, and I want to have these a little brighter. Some of this 100 men. These are right now green, but I think they need to be a little bit bluer. That's fine. Okay, why are you lifetime remove? Okay, there, now they'll stay forever. Yeah. All right, now I'm going to see how that looks. I think it's a little too busy with those. Yeah, it's a bit heavy. Drop that to 100. I don't think it's saved. Nope. We're going to take the size. We're also going to make them a little bit bigger default. I'm going to make them a little bit bigger. Let's see, this is stars. This radius, I'm going to make it half as much. Alpha will be 255. Color will be a lot whiter. So the random elements of it ensure that they're in the same spot all the time, but now it has a brighter center bit compared to the rest, and brighter with more energy would be implied as being white. I wonder if I should make the center bit by her have a bit more. Where's the volume metrics? It's still over here. I don't even need that anymore. What effect are you talking about? Slider wasn't doing anything. Oh, no, it's not a, it's actually a, it is a thing you could do in the VMTs, but a lot of the particles have multiple versions of each saved. If it has no Z on it, it'll usually say in its name at the end, no Z. And if it does, or, and then with, if it normally can be blocked by objects, it will just, it won't have that at the end. So if I have a texture that I used for some stupid reason that said no Z at the end, it has removed that part of the texture, and it just grabs from what it, from the other one then. Because normally it's, if it has a no Z version, there's a regular version too. Normally. Actually kind of works like that. Everybody that does these back legs just has to make them work for a standing position. They always just look that you cannot make them look right. Anywhere else. Thank you. didn't have that locked. I'm like, this foot's not making sense. Even I think like her back thing I think is exceptionally bright, but I almost might leave it like that. Cause it helps pull her out. Anyways, so yeah, I just gotta add more changelings around. That's kinda what I wanna do, is have this whole thing filled with them. So I probably have one actually looking down at him from here. But probably one over here, one up there, one probably looking through there, one another one on the poles here. So anyways, it is 9, so I am done. No more today. So, I will be streaming on Friday. Probably to finish up this picture. Next week on Friday, so not this Friday, but a week from Friday, because that's going to be the early release of Mass Effect. I'll probably be playing that because that's going to be out like Thursday. So yeah, I'm going to be doing that. So that stream will probably be a little different. So anyways, that's it for today. Have okay. And okay, have a big kitty. There, now you can see kitty. Rawr. So, alright, so good night. See you guys Friday. And we'll go from there. Bye bye, have coffee. Love coffee.